Okay, so we, what we do today is something interesting. We take one subject out of the large spectrum of Taijutsu and actually a pretty boring one and try to make it as interesting as alive as possible. Yeah, I mean, later on you can use gloves and focus grips and attack your opponent and you know, let's try to make something interesting. Who knows how to jump in the circle? You know, Kyodoki? Who knows Kyodoki? Your hands will suddenly grab your hand and you want to release it. I hope for myself, I remember when I was a young student, I always thought you know to do something, but you know. But later on, you know, with the wrestling, somebody grabs your hand, you want to reach in, or let's say, you reach for a weapon, for a knife, or for a stick, somebody grabs your hand, you reach for a gun, your officer, somebody grabs your hand, because then you will see it's not the hand that you need to move, but you need to move the body, and then, along with the body, to move the gun, all these different things. So, even in close range boxing, you know, you deflect the hand, you punch somebody, all of a sudden, you have a hand you grab, or he will grab your hand, try to prevent you from reaching for your knife, or from punching him, on and on and on. So, it looks like a boring subject in the beginning, but it's a very alive subject, especially for girls. You know, somebody talks to you, say, look, I'm not interested in you, you want to leave? All of a sudden, he grabs you. And this is now the moment that we want to start our way of seeing things in the Ninjutsu Academy, how things will happen. We think in certain indicators an opponent will give us. Because when people, when they students, when they learn Teodoki, they have a tendency, you know, it's like, let me be here. I will do the technique now and he will grab me, so I will give him my hand, but it's very unlikely. I'm not walking through the world, wait a second, and offering my hand for people to hold me when I'm in danger, you understand? It's very unlikely. So it will be, let's say for a second, you want to reach for something and I take your hand and I push it towards you, or you want to go away and I pull you towards me. So there are different situations. Of course, there might be static situations, but it's very unlikely that I will give him the hand. So this is very important in the beginning to understand that when you learn these things, make them alive somehow. The same is with choking. You know, sometimes you see people, they learn Chimodoki, and they do like this, and there's no need to learn the technique. You don't have to kill your partner, but you have to put some life in it. So let's say he grabs the hand for whatever reason, and we start leading like low level, but we then let's proceed on very fast from here. Yeah, we have two basic ways. One is Uchimashi Doi. This will be the hand pointing towards the floor, and I bring my hand towards my belly, and the elbow towards him. You take off the jacket, otherwise you see nothing. Okay, put the hand towards the floor, elbow towards him. This is Uchimashi Doi, just for the name now, not the technique I show. And Soto Mabashi Doi to the outside. So one is the hand to the ceiling, and one is the hand to the floor. So, but let's say he has a very, very soft hand. He grabs me in a very relaxed way, very relaxed. Maybe the hand might be strong, but his arm will be very soft. He's very controlled, very good fighter. So then it's still possible for me to somehow move my arm, and you know, but this is not how people will grab you. They will grab you like, oh, really strong as possible. So let's see, now it's hard for him, for me. If I want to do the technique, really be strong. Let me try not to let me succeed. I need power, and power in the same time he can punch me, he can kick me, many things can happen, and he's still sweet with me, I see that. Try to hold stronger, so because here I have no angle, no opportunity to do the technique. So the first thing I want to do, I want to create distance. I have two ways, or I step back, that's actually a third way with punching him, which comes later on, but let's stay from a technical point of view, hold strong. So I push myself away and I push him away, you see this? Try to resist, really strong, boom. So, like I push myself away from you, and through that I push him away from me. And now all of a sudden through this, I have the distance and the angulation to do the technique, you understand? So I give him just a small push, like, see like this, hold strong, like I push myself away from him, and in the same time I try to push him, this is not so easy, but if I do both simultaneously, all of a sudden, boom, I move. And from here it's easier. So this is the first exercise, just to get an idea. The moment he grabs strong, you push yourself away from him, and by that you push him away from you. And now all of a sudden you have the right angle to do these two techniques, Uchi and Soto Mabashi Doi. So the first exercise, try. Thank you. Push myself away, from a situation or from something can be applied to weapons. Okay, it's not just when you have a sword that you put the sword forward in a kamae. It's also somehow, because in any kamae, with weapon or without weapon, you want to project. You want to project a feeling. It can be fear, maybe because you're really afraid and you're not scared to show it, or to lure an attacker into camp. Let's say a dokuro kamae. You know, you have versions that you are hustled, that you really, that you more or less you hide the weapon, and you have big versions that come, show him the weapon. And the same is when you have seigan. Seigan is the idea that the tip of the sword is towards the eyes of your opponent, okay? So this hand is more or less to the middle dantian, the tip of the sword to the higher dantian, and this to the lower dantian. So the idea is like I push myself away from the sword, and same time I push the sword forward, so you really project the feeling. So all of your inside, your nefesh, your ruach, and neshama, all this is directed towards your opponent, so you make no mistakes. Not just that you hold a sword to him, or you're angry or something, it's all of you is concentrated into one moment, into a weapon. In Japanese they call it kentai ichiyo. Weapon and body becomes one. Weapon and person becomes one, okay? It's one principle. So now we had the idea of, let's say, go away, and we had the idea to push him. So let's immediately jump to more realistic conclusions. You want to help me?
Thank you.
Okay. He holds my hand for whatever reason, he grabs the hand, and I see in the basic, of course, that's just to recapitulate for 1 second. You have ideas, he holds strong, so this is not possible to live for me, for Soto, so I have to do this way, a long way. I do without stepping, I just want you to remember all the options. And of course, what I can do also, I can open the fingers and point it more towards his eye. It's always with a step 45 outside. If he holds stronger, there's a chance, you see, I break his balance a little. And if he hits towards me, boom, come outside for command. This is the basic form. You know, you stand here, you go 45, and come back 45. That's Soto Wabashidori. Fuchi, he grabs, you open the hand, okay? I bring the hand towards me, boom, even with a small move, hit him, and outside. These are very, very basic and beginner forms. Let's make them more real. In the moment he grabs my hand, in the moment I want to do for Soto Wabashidori, it's a 45 degree outside step, for Uchi 90 degree outside. We start with Soto. In the moment I want to do the technique. Now I already learned, I can create a little distance here, or I can, like I say, circle all the way around, or I bring the elbow in front of my body and be strong like this. But let's be more smart, let's hit the person. So while I'm doing this move, boom, I punch him. And now I stand outside. This is how I create distance in the beginning. You can do, of course, Shikan, but you can take a little. Okay, boom, like this. It's very strong, very, very strong hit to the neck. It's not in the movies, you will not die, but you will stop talking for a moment, which is very good with most people that will attack you. So, 45 degree, you start with a punch. Don't first step, because let's say I want to do this for whatever reason and he will punch me at the same time, it's too late, okay? I start with the punch, boom, and by this accelerating this move and immediately align myself again. Very simple way to start. The other side, boom, outside, and aligning myself to you. Okay, okay. Let's say you reach for the knife. This is a smart thing. I'm a lefty, but somehow it's easier for me to carry a gun or to catch a gun or a knife on the right side. If I'm here, I want to reach for the knife. See, here, if I just try to do any smart technique, he can hit me in the same time, even with his knife, many different things. So this is why I want to start, hold, boom, outside, and I'm already outside, and let's say it's just a small step, boom, you see, and I'm again outside. I cut him, and I'm again outside. Again, he needs steps to, boom, to come towards me and to reach towards me. This gives you a good distance feeling. This is why the so-called boring basics, if you apply them smartly, it's really boom, you punch, you go all the way 45, boom, all the way 45, it's called Hiraki Ashi, I think. So you can still cut him and be out of reach. And he needs more steps, this buys you time. Just very important, I believe it's not so smart to be too far away, because more than two steps will bring such an acceleration rate that, because I can only hit him as fast as my first step is. So if he's always one step away from me, he's kind of safe or he has time to react. But
let's leave the fact that he might be shocked because I want to attack him, but if I really run towards him after two steps, there will be an acceleration factor, and I will be really fast. This is something different already. This is why, by the way, for you, as much as we all like this Chinese boxing aspect of ninjutsu and regular boxing, as smart as it is, we in Hamburg, we keep the attack for beginners with ski, Urasto, Motorsto, the idea to come with a step for a very specific reason. Why? In a street attack, it's not always that people hit you one, two, three, just like in a boxing movie. Let's say even they come with a left foot and a right hand, but there will be a lot of physical presence attacking you, approaching you. And even good fighters, like they know how to box or kickbox, they are not used to this amount of physical presence attacking them. You understand? That's why at ski, it's always a good idea that you're used to the distance and the timing of a person, not just throwing a hand at you, but his heat is coming at you, not his hand. I never saw a hand attacking anybody, it's always a person. So now let's do the thing. We don't have these focus mitts, so we have to, he has to help me with his hand. Okay, the hand already stays up. Don't hit your partner too strong now, like you hold it. This will represent your face now. You can talk to yourself. I do my punch and my 45 degree forward step. And let's say, after this hit, he is kind of paralyzed for a second, he's shocked, okay? So if from these 2 feet I am aligning here, I have a middle line, and I want to step not forward towards him, I want to step on the middle line to create a lot of force. So it's one, boom, like this. Very, very strong hit. He's holding, boom, boom, to him, all the way towards him. Don't move away, because we want to train now and give you a bit more time, because there's two distinct different scenarios. The first one will be, I want to reach for something, I hit him, boom, and he's still by me, whoa, very strong hit. Most cases he will just drop. The hit coming after, they will not hit him, because he will drop. There's a lot of force, really a lot of force, because you move, boom, all your body. Make sure you don't move the body first, because first he can hit you before you hit him, and second, there is no power. Okay? All my body is behind. You see, the shoulder is not in front of the hip, the shoulder is behind the hip. Very, very strong move. We do Kihon in a second together. Second option is, I don't hit him strong enough, or he's a tough guy. Boom, you move towards me, boom, moving out. Same idea as with a knife. So, he grabs my hand, boom, I punch him, he still stands there, boom, another hit. Boom, same scenario, he runs towards me, boom, going outside, 45, and hitting him. So it's the basic principles applied to a boxing fight out of something boring as Theo Dupi. Let's do it together, Kion, sorry.
Five. Okay, imagine another cross you're standing on it, and from here, it's the hand hitting, the hip rotating, and throwing the other leg back. Boom. Okay, of course, you're your hand. So by this, if you grab his hand, boom, I hit him, he runs towards the ball, I punch him, and it will be that we need your opponent.
Dann kann man den erkennen. Bam. Blieb Partner. Schon. Bang. Samstag. Boom, you run towards me. There is always a certain moment when you drop your arms. You start, of course, here you start from zero. You do boom, and then you drop the arms, and from here you keep on hitting. But he might also hit a punch. So I always want to keep a situation, boom. Let's say he hits me, from the arms already here. Okay, arms already up. Use kamae, boku, anything, you know. Keep the arms up, because then you always have to react. This might not be strong enough. When we come to this blocking thing, let's say I was stupid, I was late, we come to this after.
What the hold up?
There is one mistake that many of you do, but it's a small mistake but crucial mistake. That if the technique has a beginning and an intermediate stage and an end, in the middle, many of you drop the hand. So you hit him nicely, you have the hand up, then you drop your hand, and then you punch him. But during the time you drop your hand, he could punch you. Okay? So the next stage we want to achieve is, let's say I was sleepy, I did this mistake, or I was caught on surprise, so I didn't react immediately with the hit. Any reason, or he just grabbed and hit you. Anything can happen, and we want to tackle this idea, how we block and when we block and what we do. But before we come to this, the same trick we use for Sotoma Bushido, he was pushing myself away from him, we want to look, have a short look into Uchima Bushido, the other technique, and from there on you will see we proceed pretty fast. We like to help again, he's holding the hand. Of course, let's recapitulate these ideas that I can just bring, hold strong. We always start, I don't want to be in front of him for any reason, punch, knife, everything. So I make a step 90 degrees outside. Before it was 45, now it's 90. During the 90 degree, the hand is closed. The moment he grabs me, I close my hand. In the moment I start the technique, I open the hand. And I open it and rotate it towards the palm facing the ground together with a 90 degree step. And from here you see it's almost, you know, the surface sign. The little finger on the hip and the thumb on the elbow. If I'm here, hold strong, there's no way. Hold even stronger, you see it's just the hip turning and propelling, so to speak, the motion from the elbow forward. So from here it's easier. There's two versions. One is more Takamatsu style, he really holds strong, it's like I pull him and come back with Urasto. And then there's one that I learned from my teacher, it's more strong, boom, hitting him with the elbow and immediately punching back. So it's more an elbow hit than a hand release. This is basic. But if I do it here, hit me same time, I always have the problem with the second hand, I have to block somehow. So in the moment he grab and hit, and I lift, I try to keep the hand and hold, punch, whoop, see? We do once without the punching. I'm not doing it on a horizontal scale, but while I do it, I kind of lift the arm. So he hits me, then of course, secure arm, Jumonji like we had last time, and from here, boom, I can lift, punch, and block him. So just try the moment he holds my hand, so you lift the arm while you do it. So immediately when he hits you, there's something in between, okay? And from here you can punch him and go on. So try, when you do the hand release, not on the floor, but while going outside, lifting your arm. Enjoy. Nice. He came up with something nice, really beautiful.
Can you show it?
He moves the wrong leg, but by this staying a very interesting distance. See? But you don't even need to block with it. It's strong.
Don't need to release.
Hold strong. Time. Whoa. It's enough if I lift. Because the latest point of relief will be more. No need, just to protect your face. So let's get more the problems. What will be with the head? Holding the hand, and I, for some reason, I'm being surprised, or I forget to hit him, or I'm injured, I have a cut in the any reason, just stupidity, which can be, human beings are stupid. So people, when they block, in ninjutsu we have always this 45 degree principle with many things. So you can say the arm, this arm will be not straight, not 90 degree, will be like 45 degrees. And the arm will not exactly block with the side, and not like this in Taekwondo, also this will be 45 degrees. Interesting for you, let's say the come in knife, let's say the knife for a second. I don't say it's the smartest thing to do, but I want you to take the backside for a second. If I, for some reason, I'm scared, I'm surprised, all of a sudden come a knife, I put my hand up, you see, you will cut all the muscle. See that? From here, you just take it up, it will cut all the muscle. If I block like this, he's doing soft, but if there will be a contact, he will hit the bone, and after he will go all the way like this and cut the muscle, just the other side. But if it's 45, he will start on the smaller part of the muscle, and after, won't be feel, nothing but bone. So if you have to be stupid in the smart way. So if you keep your arms up just defensively, use this 45 degree principle of keeping the arm in an angulation, that there will be more bone to cut and less flesh. For other reasons, let's say, without holding the hand for a second, and I want you to do it in a way that you don't injure me, but people will see what will happen. I want you to hit, let's say my face will be here in a second, I want you to hit the arm
let's say, 60% strong. Then you do a snap, imagine my face is here, and you hit the arm from outside. Oh, strong, really strong. You don't have to go away, just go in and hit. Strong, really strong. Let me show one, you keep the arm strong, boom, like this. Hit it strong. I try to resist him now, I make strong, and you make stronger. See, no chance for me. Now I want him, I put my face online, so you see it's no bullshit. Now, if I make a mistake, he will hit the face. Now hit stronger, even double the time. Do. Boom. But not here, hit my face. Boom, strong. You see, it's just a small movement, just a small movement, that will show you that you can block strong force even with a small movement of strength. If you try defensively, there's also something called own strength. If you're scared, you know, like this, the arm will collapse because I can make as strong as I want, hit, hit, hit. Oh, really, don't be shy, don't be shy. No chance for me, hit again. See, just a small movement will stop him. So if he could understand, this will be the same for sparring, for ball, for anything. If I would just keep the arms up, the arm will collapse with my hand. No way of doing it. If you do this parade, it's called in French or in German, you know, it's a parade. In the hospital, they know exactly, if somebody hits somebody with a stick or knife, the arm is broken, they call it parade break, because people just lift the arm and think it's enough. And first this will break and hit again, it will hit your face. So don't block in a defensive way. This is why we do Judo no Chibuke basic. We don't do like a block, okay, but we do boom, a hitting movement. It's getting away from a situation and in the same time attacking what's attacking me. It's not a defensive move. The stepping is defensive. Why it's defensive? Let's say I hit him and you stay on the ground and block it anyway. Well, whatever you want to. I hit him, boom, I come with a knife, immediately I step and I punch him. Get it? But if he attacks me anyway, I get surprised, boom, I block, so I have time to take out my knife or my stick or push people I don't like in front of me or take people that I like and put them behind me, you understand? This is how we work. So now we're here, he's holding the hands. We remember, 90 degree, we're standing on such a cross, come join me on the line. 90 degrees to the side, same time I open the hand, boom, and same time you hit me as strong as you can, boom, and I block. Now I come or outside, or again, boom, or inside, and push it. One more time, the other side. 90 degrees outside, one slowly, open the hand, and this is a small movement, boom. And now, your job is, I do on you, don't do nothing. I grab, boom, and I punch it, okay? I grab, boom, and I punch it. You do the same to me, boom, outside, okay? Boom, and I move outside, 45, boom, 90 degrees. And from here, I can decide, boom, I want to go inside, or I want to go outside, even with basic movement. Blocking, getting inside instead, same way before, or getting outside. So this is the one way of blocking if somebody really, really hits you. So with your partner, I recommend you, I hold you, you just stand there, let's say you want to go away, I hold you, and now, like you can even have these intermediates, wait, okay, or he gets out, or I hit him, boom. So, one more time, I keep the hand, I hit a little stronger, boom. I hit a little stronger, see, stronger. Very easy for you, see, very small movement, it hurts me more than you. Otherwise, I will never find out if I block the right way. This is one thing. So don't hit him here, but hit him on the face. Or if you hit him on the face, don't block here. Because the hand should be always your kamae. Let's say you have Hokuno kamae, or Koseno kamae, or Jumonji. It's always a bit like a window, and you're looking out of this window. But if you are like here, you see nothing. Only your nose can smell the cake from grandma, but you don't see. So protect your head. Second thing is the hand should not be 90 degrees. If my hand is in a 90 degree angle,
work with
the
him,
arm.
Work with him.
Okay. You push, just push, don't punch, just push. Keep pushing. And even towards me, see, that's not so strong. I make stronger, you also, it's not so strong. But if the arm is in a 45 degree angle and you push, you see, it's much stronger. If you push towards my face, it holds much stronger. Once it's 90 degree, it collapses easier. The same lesson you have in Tai Chi, when the arms are crossed, it's called Peng. If I'm here, push towards me, it's hard to hold. If the arm is here, it's just the structure keeping it. And from here, you can hit the same what we have in ninjutsu. So,
The arms as high as possible, more than 90 degrees, and the arm is turned outside. And do 4 or 5 times, each one of you, and each time hit a little faster, a little stronger. You can have the second hand already ready if this is too slow for you. One hand here, boom, and just block. So get used to have a small impulse move, boom, that will help you to prevent getting your face smashed. Killing and healing was always connected to the power. With the last thing, he holds any hand, he hits me, boom. And some people, they will not try to hit again. He tries to hit again, boom. This is the time when I can hit him. But they will also try to put pressure with his arm towards me. So I have to release the arm, come to the other side. From here, do all different interesting things. This is what I want you to start very slowly. First, more or less without stepping. So he hits, but the hit you can do strong. Boom. The pressure towards me. So I let go. Here I have sort of corset. Boom. The first hit, the second hit, and from here, boom. Can go on and do all different interesting things. Over time. Hit. More pressure. Boom. Crossing the arm. From hitting, breaking the arm. You have sort of a motekyaku, kicking him. And do you feel that it's good? So do umote and uagyaku at the same time. So basically, more pressure towards me, so I cross the line, hit him, bump. All the basic techniques could come up, sorry, from here. And you see, the same time he falls, you do another umotegyaku. So while he twists himself, you feel he falls counterwise to the umotegyaku. Just play with it a little. He falls. You fall really like a professional. Very, very soft. Yeah, very nice. Or somebody who moves both
sides. Year of practice. Year of practice.
Okay, guys, come. I see nobody's doing even remotely what I ask you. So let's do, we start from a different point of view. Come on, help me. He's holding the hand, and I'm already here. We're in this situation. He hit me, and I blocked. No steps whatsoever. The arm up, we do really slowly. So I do two things now same time. The lower hand, the hand that he's holding, okay, so I'm doing like this, so I hope everybody see. The lower hand that he's holding, he's doing uchi mawashi dori. The upper hand where he's still pressuring towards me, let's say even as a stick or a knife, I make, some people are smart, they cut like this, or many do many, or I want to reach towards him. So now this guy, he wants to reach towards me and I make like this. So the elbow could be boom, straight to his face 1-2 times. And in the same moment I do this, we're coming here. Kusei no kamai, jumonji no kamai, boom, elbow, urasto, boom, another punch and a handshake, boom, breaking the arm. And from here, if you still want, you see what I do. Not the basic way I grab for the head or anything. I reach for the second hand. I'm still scared he has a knife or something. I reach for the second hand. And now I come inside, lock the foot, and let him turn into something like a motegyaku. But this is all the bullshit after, this nobody needs. Really important is, he's holding the hand, the pressure, and I do like this, and at the same time, grab over, punch, boom. See, it's one hit, second hit, third hit, fourth hit, boom. And from here, go all the way down. Okay? This is what I want you to do. Hand get up. Always you need you to control the foot. Maybe, boom, there will be somebody else. You have to take a weapon and I now get up, boom, cut him and go to the next one. Always use Thai Sabaki and look around because it's very unlikely he will be the only one. It's kind of everything is possible, but everything is 100% unrealistic.
I was so surprised because I didn't believe it's trying to kill me, you know, for 1 minute.
Now let's take these drills and put them together. I recommend you, because it's an open drill, you will not know how it ends. It's not free randomly, but I say preview to it. And what we do after many times in our academy, we start with the scenario, and after it goes on free, let's say for a minute. You know, trainer stands by and watch for a minute how one of them finishes the situation with a gun or with a knife or just tie it. So we do together. As I said, I do in this example 5 times now. Okay. So the first example will be, I do always slow for him because you do it now first time, this scenario. So I recommend you to do it slow. You have 2 options now. Well, option 1 is in the moment, no, don't give me the hand. In the moment I reach for your hand, you immediately hit me. Okay, boom. And if I still stay, comes the step in. Second hand, the left. Boom, and the hit. Or I reach for you and you hit me. Boom, I run. Wait a second. Do again. Boom, you have to move. When I run towards you, boom, this. Okay? This can be. Or I do a little faster. Not for him to get insulted and say, who is faster, I am faster. No, we want to learn together. I get a little faster and he has to block now, okay? This is the second situation. Boom, he has to block and from here you can hit in any way and you still have to get rid of the hand. Boom, in any way, do, same time. Right, also this I wouldn't recommend because then the face is open. Do again, boom, and do the uchi and outside. From here you can do many space finishes, okay? Or I give you the situation, I do like this, and I can pressure, and now, boom, exactly. Okay? So, till the moment I grab him, he doesn't know if I give him time to hit me, and now he has to react to me still standing, or running towards him, or he doesn't know if I grab him and hit him right away. And then he has to do this or this, what we learned in the beginning. So it's an open drill somehow, and he doesn't know what will be. Okay? Boom, pressure, boom, do something, yeah. And again, and always get up, always the eyes towards the opponent, okay? In my dojo, this is a, I wouldn't say mistake, something we miss, that I like to study from Yossi when he's by me, or when I see him, or when I see the videos. We don't do so much Ukemi in Ninjutsu Academy, not so good, for a certain reason. And the reason is true as much as your version of what you learned is true. I don't want to learn all these breakfalls because from my teacher, we learn situations. Let's say we're in a fight, I throw him, you just bang, okay? So first of all, let's say this might be a discotheque. And he do this, there will be glass on the floor, girls crying, stepping on his arm. If nothing of this happened, boom, it's me stepping on his arm, okay? And general, in a fight, where you want to be, here or here, okay? So what we want to do is in any throw, he will just fall, roll, get up, and free wrestling, or patchwork, or free stand-up sparring. So you connect taijutsu, ukemi, and boxing, and jujitsu, groundwork, and all these things, okay? By the way, if you want, we can also take a few minutes on groundwork, ninjutsu hammock applications, because I think as much as I love Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, Gracie Jiu-Jitsu, especially for what we experience in Israel right now, you see this is a wonderful sport as much as football or table tennis or anything which, I don't know, girls with short skirts, what you like, tennis or whatever, but nothing for the real world, okay? It's not meant to be for fighting for real, because it is a different situation. So you understood the drill? I will do 5 times, he will not know what I do, I give him time to hit me, always hit me, you have to hit me, I do a new move, you have to hit me in a way that I move, okay? Because if I don't move, you have no reason to follow or I have no space to come towards you. You don't have to do too strong, just be warm a bit, move him, so something will happen. But be nice, remember your friends, you want to be friends tomorrow, enjoy, do the truth. Before, if we, I don't know if we do it today, but before we combine it with the wrestling drill, let's look into the same 2 techniques. Uchi Mawashidori and Soto Mawashidori. Soto was to the outside, Uchi was to the inside from a more close range situation. Let's take the wrestling position, holding the hand, strong. Of course, there are many things I can do here, but for some reason I want to stay with this technique now. So what I do is holding strong. If I put the hand towards the body, put strong, okay, whoop, and release it. And from here, boom, it's upper can, boom, an elbow, okay? Many hold strong, whoop, release it, or grab over the leg, and do many interesting things from here that I can control both hands best and the face. Not to prevent him from grabbing or reaching for anything that I have on me or he has on him, okay? So now you can frisk him and see if he has money or anything. And the same we do with Uchi Mawashidori. In this grappling situation,
Hand is close to the chest this time. Boom, I turn and just the elbow inside, and from here you get all the way inside as you do. And second, let him fall into Uragyaka, for example. One more time. Bam, he's holding the hand. Boom, elbow to the face, and from here inside. Oh, sorry. Okay, you reach for the eye, put your head in the neck so you don't have to see his face here, like this. And always look for control. Look for fingers, anything you can get, the eyes, the balls, whatever you get. So, Uchimamashidori, the hand comes to the chest, or the chest comes to the hand, I get up, boom, elbow to the face, see? I make like this here, it's not much space, I make the hand like this. So here, it's very hard for me, even like this, it's very hard for me to hit. Here I have much more space. And here I see I rotate, I lock the arm, inside, inside, inside. Here, many different versions for to control the arm. Just not like this, okay? It only works in the movies, the YouTube movies. And the other version was from here, boom, free, boom, and hit. I'm kata mark, and from here, anything can be. I don't care what, if you put pressure towards me, boom, okay? Interestingly, many times you touch the inside of his leg, which means he has a reason to kick. Okay, and from here you can lift him and attack you with the leg. But this is not so important. Important is this and this. Enjoy. It's hard for him to get out anywhere, so this hand can be weight for Takeuri. From here you can do Yokanagara Naname, Tomoenage, or any different thing here.
Sion has a question.
And I didn't understand how you did it.
Me too, also. I don't remember so much what I did because I have to go with the situation.
Ah, because you put the hand like this, try to kick you, and then you throw him like this way.
Was probably, look, we were here. You hold the hand.
Okay.
This move, I hit the elbow. Okay. I lock the arm. And from here I come in all the way, this one goes. And the other
the
one...
The outside.
So this one goes like this.
Yeah. And if I want to kick...
I put the hand here, so you kick. Okay.
This one?
Yes.
Okay.
Really?
Okay. This?
No, תביא לו ברכייה. תביא לו בבטן ברכייה.
My head is free. Okay. You do Ganseki on the face, on okay. The leg, and of course...
Again, I need it for the video, because I moved the camera.
It's okay?
Yeah.
Great. Okay. Inside, I put the weight low, try to kick. The arm is here, so you can't kick. Or you just wait for the leg lock.
Okay. Thank you.
They're just thinking about randori now. It happens all the time in randori. Somebody grabs you.
Okay, guys. Before we come in, out of that, so let's play with them for one moment, okay? The first one was that he holds the hand. He holds my hand this one because I want to reach for anything like this. So I open from here, boom, hit him, and after, boom, I come here to this situation. I open up. So for him, if my arm is here, remember we had hold, we had close to the body, we had opening Soto Mawashidori, and then boom, hitting him, or hitting him this, and then close to the body, circling around, and I really keep a tight lock. Of course, all these funny things from here, but not necessary. I like to keep the head open because I don't know what we're doing in a second. We are in a wrestling situation, so I try to put him a little down so it's not so easy for him to kick. Okay? And here, so let's think about this arm. Which way he has for this arm to escape? Very difficult. It's working, I don't lock it. This is the lazy version. That's where my own person. For him now, very hard to get this arm for him. So I keep the arm open and close to my body, and my body closes the arm. Like, so the only word, the only way for his arm to escape is here. Okay? And right into the way he can. See that? Because his hand is never strong. It's just somebody, he wants to get out of the hand's relaxed, and he falls right into Takeuri. So I'm here, he
his hand gets out. You see, my hand is cupped. It waits for the takeori. And from here, you can do 1 million things. You can do yoku nagare naname. You can just skip like this. Kick him and go inside because he will fall in this direction and the hand will stay with me. Boom. Very good for randori. Happened many times in situation. The second idea, you hold the hand, was boom, elbow, and put my hand close. We have very interesting way of doing Ganseki Nage. The first thing is I cut my hand on top of his shoulder and bring him close. Okay? So now it's hard to escape. Okay? Because if I do like this, the arm will just get out. Nobody will keep it like in this form. So I come, and from here, I come to this situation, grabbing my clothes, his eye, my ear, anything, or here, anything. Try to get the arm out. It's very hard, you see? Plus, put the head in the neck. Okay, it's very hard now for him to get the arm out. So now we have three basic forms. Straight the arm like this, straight the arm like this, or keep it warm, close like this. From here, you can do your thing. You will not get his arm out so easy. Because if I do that second, he wants to... No way. Of course, we have... Get the arm out. This can be. Okay? But you do only if you want. You decide to give him this window, so you put the hand close the window. That's right.
סגור הוק קדמי. סגור את ההוק של יד שמאל שלך. סגור את היד פנימה. אוקיי. אם היא סגורה ויש לך את האנדר הוק, הוא לא עובר גארד.
Yesh me ein, that something is being created out of nothing. So yin and yang is maybe for you just a way to explain how we can see life, how we perceive our reality, that there might be anything anywhere, but it's all what we have here, our life, is basically just an illusion. An illusion that's very real for us, of course, but it's made for us so we can bring sort of something out of nothing, or to help that process. But it's not really important this mishmash strudel sign. Important is there is something outside that is looks like ku, but it's ju, that is really existing, and that all what is here, it looks like so real, but it's actually not. Okay. Good night.
היתרונות. תודה שלום.
צילמת איפה הקו? יש פה מצלמת מהירות, בטוח.
איזה סיבה הייתה לנו בקריים? תקופה טובה?
פתיחת שנה.
איך?
פתיחת שנה, בהתחלה היה טרנסים, אחרי זה כברת.
תגידי דו, שומעתי, דאג שם, מה אני יודע?
מי שעושה שיקום כסף לסמינר, נותן אותו רם עכשיו ואני אשבל.
לא ראיתי, תעשה שוב. חכה רגע שהפוקוס ייכנס לי.
יאללה, מספיק.